there you can see now, this is how we receive the wool from the farmers, Karakulia local farmers. As you can see, this is not even washed. And then once we get it done like this, on the other side there, we're having a place where we do the washing only by hand. And then after washing, then you can see now, this is how we dry the wool up here. The one is lying on top, lying here. And then now once the wool is getting dry here, then we take it to the carding room. Let me show you the carding room. This is the carding. This area we call it a carding room. And then this one, this is the carding machine. What it does, we're putting the wool from that side, and then it's coming through here. It means now afterward, the wool has to be nice and soft, just more like a cotton. This machine we call it a willow machine. What do we do? First of all, we're putting the wool through this machine and then go through the other side. And then from there, the wool has to be not so nice, not so soft, but you can see there's a big difference. That's why now from the willow machine, then we're putting the wool through the carding machine, which is this one, the big one. We make a threads, or maybe we can send it through the dyeing process. Okay. The drying area, where we do the drying here. Depend to the weather, but you know that our weather is not so good. It can take maybe even a week to dry. It just depends to the weather. This area, we do the washing here, we do the dyeing here, and then also we treat the wool against the mold. Not the same time, but we put it in a different time, different date. Yeah. As you can see, he's not cooking, but this is the way the wool is being washed. Yeah. Because if you squeeze the wool too much, then it should become like a ball. This is the beginning of the weaving process. This is okay. what you're doing. It's a custom made. Somebody sent a picture from South Africa, and I can see now out of it because we make it better. And I will put this a bit behind here. And now what you do now is just copy from the pen in the back. And at the end of the day, it should be exactly like this. This is what you do. the cheetahs. And then the following the pet in the back is all. And then what you do here, we have a different weavers. As you can see, some of the weavers they're just doing that they're putting just a cord in their mind as he goes. But some of them they have a pattern. But like him, that is here, he doesn't need a pattern. It means he does his own design as he goes. Here, the one who's sitting here, he does his own design as well. He does there's nothing in the back like a pattern. He's one of the learners. Because what he means is that we need a new blood. Because as you can see, most of the people that are getting old, then of course now we're getting a young chap like him, just to train in just do the weaving here. There's a lady coalition, Elaine, and what she do here now, she this is the elephants, which we call an elephant parade. As you can see, an elephant on the lines, and there's a mama, there's papa, mama, and two, and there are two babies. They are on their way to the water holes. And then also you can see now to make it, see, there's a pattern here, the elephants. And then here, you can even see how we do the warping, because as you can see, this loom, the warping was finished. Now, this is how we set up the new warping. And then in the corner there, there's another gentleman called Johannes. What he does his own design as he goes as well. And then you can see this is one of the big, not the biggest, but one of the big room in our company. And then you can see here, there's a thing like a pedal, which he used just to change the warping so that if you want to change the warping now, this is what he does. It's more like a clutch. If you want to change your gear, of course you need a clutch. And then for him to change the warping, this is what he needs. And then also this is one of his own design as well, because not to make things like that, it's up to him. And then you see now, when it's coming to the finishing product, and things like this, it can be used either maybe for the wall as a wall hanging, or it can be used maybe for the floor as a carpet. And the good thing is that, now you can see that side, if I turn it around, it's the same. It means that they are 100% reversible, all of them. The finishing touch. What you do here, now once all the cloth coming from all the loom, we bring it on here, where we do the last touch. We do this is what you just do the to cut all the fluffs, and then we have to make sure that at the bottom they be braided like this, top and bottom, so that it can be used. And then also from here, of course, we can put the price and we can start selling to our client. And then also what we do in our company, we export them all over the world. Moses Elau. The boy was born in the north, in our Angwena region, many years ago. And then I came to Swakopmund just to find a job. And then I found myself getting a job in Karakulia, whereby I started as a cleaner. Then, but that, of course, I became a criminal for the experience, stealing just experience among the staff, my colleagues. And then luckily there was a lady, she was a designer, and then she used to call me all the time just to come and help her when she wants, whenever she needs somebody to just come and help her. And then by that time, her idea was to relax, but my idea was to learn, which was very good. And then from there, then I learned from her. And then once I got a job somewhere, because I took over from her. And then the owner of the company, she sent me to the art school, just to study art for 2 years. And then this is how I study how to do the designing and all that stuff, yeah. And then as I said, I was a criminal for the experience. Then I become an assistant to the designer, then later I become a designer. I become assistant to the supervisor, then later I become a supervisor. I become assistant to the manager, then I become a manager. I become assistant to the sales. It's just like this. And then the first owner, she retired in 2006, and then a couple took over from South Africa. And then we've been with them only for 3.5 years, and then because of the global crisis, the company was down. And then I've been thinking, should I go and look for a job where I'm going to start as a cleaner again, or should I go to the bank and borrow the money, then I can take over the company? Then what happened now? I went to the bank, DBN, submitted an application, which was declined for the first time. And then I didn't give up. I tried the second one. The second one was approved. Then I took over the company in 2011, whereby I started only with 3 employees. But now, as you can see, like the inside, I'm having more than 15 employees. And then Karakulia is one of the biggest companies in Swakopmund. Let me say that. And then, of course, most of the people, they come to Swakopmund only just to see Karakulia, like a tourist. Many of the tourists, like this morning, I had about maybe 10 emails from all over the world. People said we've been to your place many years ago, but now we'd like to have a new company, all this stuff. It means though, once the people buy things from Karakulia, they don't want to remember Karakulia, but to remember Namibia. You see? Because whenever they see their product in their house, they think, oh, we bought this from Namibia. They bought this from Karakulia, but now they're carrying the name of Namibia outside their country, or in their country. And then as you can see, under my management, I'm here, I had about maybe 6 awards. The first one, it was the Made in Namibia Expo 2011, which was a regional award for the Erongo region. And then I had the one from the DBN, which was the Good Business Award. I had the one from NMA, which was the first a gold and a silver. And then I have one from the NCCI, SME Most Progressive. And then I have, like this year, we had one from also from NMA, SME Most Manufacturing Company in Namibia. It's not because of the money which we sell, but only the way we manufacture from nothing to something. As you can see at the back, Karakulia can do anything. This is one of the last suppers for Jesus and his disciples. You see them? And then you can see that this is an Atlantic Ocean. Most of the people, they never heard about the seahorse. This is one of the seahorse. You see? It means here, you can design anything you like, and of course, you can put it for you in the form of whatsoever. And then of course for the tourist, if you are in Namibia looking for Karakulia, we are based in Swakopmund, in the street called Rakotoka. It's Rakotoka Street. To own the business, you don't need to have a degree whatsoever, but to run the business, you need to be studying. There's a big difference between just to own the business and to run the business. Because for sure, to run the business, you need to be educated. I don't say I'm educated, I didn't finish my school. I'm just lucky. Because I went through many, like a workshop and a training. That's why I learned more. But now I realize that to run a business, even a business like this, of course you need to be educated. Otherwise, because I think like our client, they only from all over the world. It means you need to know how to communicate with all the people from all over the world. Good, thank you. You can do a button.